Hare Krishna.
Those who are not humble often help us to become humble. Sometimes we have to deal with some people who are arrogant, who are self-obsessed, who are egotistic. And it's very difficult to deal with such people. Now, if we have to deal with them rather than complaining and blaming, we can see the opportunity to deal with the situation of dealing with the non-humble as an opportunity to ourselves become humble. Humility is a very important virtue, both on the spiritual path as well as in any well-informed, mature social interactions. Krishna talks about humility as the first characteristic of knowledge. In 13.8, the Bhagavad-Gita states, Amanitvam adambhitvam ahimsa shantirarjavam acharyopasanam shaucham sthairyam atmavinigraha. So, amanitvam adambhitvam, not seeking one's own honor, not seeking one's own prestige, not putting on a show to seek prestige from others. So, humility this is. Krishna says this is a characteristic of knowledge. Now, humility is not just seen by how we say fold our hands in front of someone, or how we stand up in the presence of somebody who is senior, or how we bow down before God. Yes, all these are important, but these are primarily gestures. Humility is seen much more in our behaviors when we interact with others. And if somebody is humble and respectful, it is relatively easy to be humble and respectful. Of course, if we have no humility, then we will see others' humility as a sign of weakness and may try to exploit and dominate them. But if the other person is humble and we are also striving to be humble, it's relatively easy to be humble with them. But just as muscles grow, not just by lifting weights that are easy to lift, but by lifting weights that are difficult to lift. Similarly, dealing with humble people is like lifting weights that are easy to lift. Dealing with non-humble people is like lifting heavy weights. Of course, we cannot lift such a heavy weight that it injures us. So similarly, if people are so arrogant and dismissive that they just dominate us and walk all over us, then we may have to create a distance between them and us and do whatever is necessary separate from them. But if some people are just difficult, they are a little demanding, a little arrogant. But if we learn the skill of dealing with them effectively, that is like lifting a weight that is slightly beyond our capacity, that will help us develop our muscles. Similarly, dealing with people who are not humble can often help us to become humble. And by not taking their intentional or unintentional barbs seriously, by not letting they may intentional or unintentional snubs seriously, by all these small things we learn humility. So of course, for developing humility, it is important that we stay purposefully centered on Krishna. If our service to Krishna requires us to deal with someone who is not humble, then we don't let the lack of respect coming from that person distract us from Krishna. At the same time, if that person just stops us from serving Krishna entirely, then we may keep a distance and we may humbly but firmly move onwards in our journey with Krishna and let them do what they want. But in general, if we don't see people who are not humble as a burden, but as an opportunity to strengthen our humility muscles, then not only can we interact more positively with them, but gradually by our spirituality and our humility, we can even infuse some humility in them and thus transform them. And irrespective of whether they got transformed or not, Krishna sees that we are dealing with a difficult person gracefully, and Krishna will gift us with humility and bhakti. And that will be a lasting, eternal gain for us, irrespective of how that particular interaction or relationship turns out. Thank you. Hare Krishna.